So this is the building maker file that we brought into SketchUp, and the match photo tutorial does a great job of showing how to convert this to an Energy Plus model, but I thought I'd just do a quick demonstration here. I'm going to have to explode this, and then I'm going to explode it again. The reason is that the whole building maker model was one primitive or one group, and the model itself may have had four or five separate pieces. Each of those would have come in their groups. So exploding it twice gets you back where you want to be. I'm going to cut everything there. I'm going to create a zone, and I'm going to go into that zone and choose paste in place. And I'll have an Energy Plus model. The surfaces know what they are. Again, following the match photo tutorial, it shows you how to split this up into multiple zones, which you would want to do for this. Instead of having the whole building as one zone, break it into smaller zones. But you could do things here too. Also, I could split my base surface up. I'm going to use the copy tool. The move tool becomes a copy tool. So there's a different construction here versus here. It's actually balconies that have more depth, but just for the demonstration now, if I orbit around, I can apply a different construction to this base surface than I can to this base surface. Using the same technique, you can use the photograph to help you with your windows. So I can put a large window from over here over to here. Windows cannot run exactly to the edge of a surface, so you have to leave a little space on the sides. But anyway, that's the basic idea. And you can go to the match photo tutorial to learn more about splitting this up into multiple zones. Because this is a rectangle, you actually have a really easy option, which I'm going to show you. So again, we didn't care about the textures that came with this building. We just cared about the overall height. So if I know how high an individual floor is, I could actually just make this smaller here, and then I could copy multiple times and say times 10. That may still be too short, although it's actually pretty close. Of course, I was making up my floor heights, but so you need to be a little more informed, either using photo textured information or something else to do that. But so now you have all the zones you need. You can run your surface matching, and you're ready to go. Anyway, that's all I'm going to do for this, just showing the basic concept of how that works. So hopefully that is a tool you'll find useful to use.